Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Harshita Kothari, I'm a chartered accountant by profession and I've been living in Dubai since 2 years. On basis of my experience and my knowledge, I'll be sharing you the cost of living in Dubai. So if you have received a job opportunity in Dubai or if you're planning to visit Dubai in order to get a job, you can analyze the feasibility according to the fixed cost that you're going to incur while living in Dubai. I will be dividing the cost that you will be incurring into 4 parameters. The first one is the rental cost. Now this video is solely for the people who are willing to come as a bachelor and not for family. So if you are willing to come as a bachelor, the first would be the rental cost that you have to pay. In Dubai, the rental cost is really very high. So the rental cost would be dependent upon the area where you're living. That could be inside Dubai, that could be in Sharjah. It will differ according to the areas. It could be the feasibility, whether the metro is near to you or it is far away. What are the food options available? What are the connecting channels to that? What is the convenience or what is the development of that particular place? I was living in Bird Dubai near Al Khalidi. So I had around 7 to 8 minutes connectivity from the metro. I had supermarkets nearby, I had Bakrumoedi, East City Mart, I had a lot of vegetarian options to eat. I had Meena Bazaar to my walking distance. So considering all those feasibility, my rent was 1000 dirham for a month, which is approximate 20,000. I did not pay the Wi-Fi cost, Deva cost, that was borne by the landlord itself as I was living in the shared apartment. My room consisted, like, I had one more roommate and I lived in a flatmates. If you're planning to live in Sharjah, the cost could be less expensive as Sharjah is cheaper as compared to Dubai, so you can save on your rent. And if you're planning to live in Bird Dubai, you have a lot of food options, and in Bird Dubai the rentals are high as compared to the other parts in Dubai. So if you're a non-vegetarian or if you're comfortable living to the other place where you can cook, you can look for the other options as well. So for this place, the only drawback was that I had to share my apartment with other flatmates. If you do not want to share the apartment, you can look for a studio, you can look for a space that would cost you around 2,000, 2,500, 3,000 per month, depending upon the area in which you live and the size and the location of the particular place. Now, the second parameter is the food cost. The food cost would be dependent upon whether you're cooking your food both the times, whether you're ordering it from outside, whether you're having the food delivery channels, depending upon the pattern or depending upon the diet you have. So, I used to actually cook my lunch and I used to eat my dinner outside. So approximate food cost that I was incurring was 700 dirhams per month, which is around 14,000 per month. But this does not include the food that you eat outside, like in big restaurants or on your weekends. So that depends upon your budget and that depends upon your liking and disliking. Now the third cost and the major cost is the transportation cost. The public transport in Dubai are metro, bus and taxis. Taxis, the basic fare for taxis is 12 dirham. The meter starts with 12 dirham depending upon the range where you go. And for the metros, you have 3 dirham, 5 dirham, you have 5 dirham, 7 dirham and 10 dirham depending upon the route and depending upon the number of stops that you take. And the bus services also have these three range. You can also go for monthly pass if you wish in order to save the cost if you're going to travel frequently. I had company transportation, so I did not incur the transportation cost. But the transportation cost could be around 300 to 500 dirham. So roughly your cost would be around 2100 dirham to 2300 dirham for a month. So if you have salary more than that, or if you're looking for a salary which is higher to that, this should be your basic parameter if you're considering it. Now the fourth is is the variable cost, that is the entertainment cost, shopping cost, medical expenses. In case you have a car, the fuel expenses, parking expenses, salary expenses. It could be the insurance expense if your company is not paying for that. It could be the visa expense if your company is not paying for that. And it could be the other expenses depending upon your lifestyle, depending upon your disliking, liking. It could be on the basis of how much you're willing to spend or how much you are fond of thing that you want to spend further. But the three options which I gave in the beginning are fixed costs. So if you're able to recover those costs, if your salary is higher than those costs, you can actually decide to move to Dubai. Actually, people say that Dubai is really expensive, but it depends upon the way you live. It depends upon your pattern. You can actually save if you are a smart shopper. You can shop where you have sale. You can actually do smart shopping. You can cook at home to save, or maybe you can take different services in order to budget your shop. But if you're living in Dubai, you should have a budget. You should actually track down your expenses so that you have a control over your expenditure. So yeah, these are the major expenses that you would be incurring. So on the basis of that, you can determine whether it's feasible for you to move to Dubai or not. In case you have any further question, you can comment down in the comment section. In case you have any other queries, you can comment down. I'll be replying to them. Thank you for watching the video. Please like, share and subscribe if it was informative to you. Thank you so much for watching.